feels like they can relate. I guess words are a motherfucker. They can be great, or they can degrade, or even worse, they can detain. It's like these kids hang on every single statement we make, like they worship us, plus all the stores ship us platinum. Now how the fuck did this metamorphosis happen? From standing on corners and porches just rapping to having a fortune, no more kissing ass. But then these critics crucify you, journalists try to burn you, fans turn on you, attorneys all gonna turn it to get their hands on every dime you have. They want you to lose your mind every time you mad, so they can try to make you out to look like a loose cannon. Any dispute won't hesitate to produce handguns. That's why these prosecutors wanna convict me, strictly just to get me off of these streets quickly. But all they kids be listening to me religiously, so I'm signing CDs while police fingerprint me. They're for the judge's pardon, but it's grudges against me. If I'm such a fucking menace, this shit doesn't make sense, B. It's all political. If my music is literal and I'm a criminal, how the fuck can I raise a little girl? I couldn't, I wouldn't be fit to. You're full of shit too, Carrera. That was a bitch that hit you. The judge, it was my fault, and I'll get sued. See what these kids do, hear about us toting pistols, and they wanna get one, cause they think this shit's cool. Not knowing we really just protecting ourselves, we entertainers. Of course the shit's affecting ourselves, you ignoramus. But music is reflection of self, we just explain it. And then we get our checks in the mail, it's fuck the painted. How we can come from practically nothing to being able to have any fucking thing that we wanted. That's why we sing for these kids who don't have a thing, except for a dream and a fucking rat magazine, who post pinup pictures on their walls all day long, idolize their favorite rappers and know all their songs. Or for anyone who's ever been through shit in their lives, till they sit and they cry at night, wishing they died. Till they throw on a rap record and they sit and they vibe with nothing to you, but with the fucking shit in their eyes. That's why we seize the moment, try to freeze it and own it, squeeze it and hold it, cause we consider these minutes golden. And maybe they'll admit it when we're gone. Just let our spirits live on through our lyrics that you hear in our songs, and we can
was Eminem and Sing for the Moment. Up next, I've got Like Toy Soldiers, and then I'm gonna just quit some of the event. Let me put my tongue back in. Let me super glue and sellotape it in. To keep losing it. Then I've got Avenged Sevenfold after Eminem with Almost Easy.
I'm bored. Let's do something else.
I got this book. My dad gave it to me.
Thank you. composure. Even though I hold the weight of the whole world on my shoulders, I ain't never supposed to show it. My crew ain't supposed to know it. Even if it means going toe to toe with the Benzino, it don't matter. I never drag them in battles that I can handle unless I absolutely have to. I'm supposed to set an example. I need to be the leader. My crew looks for me to guide them. Something never just pop off. I'm supposed to be beside them. And chop it, I tried to squash it. It was too late to stop it. There's a certain line you just don't cross, and he crossed it. I heard him say Haley's name on the song, and I just lost it. It was crazy. This f***ing wavy on some Jay-Z and Nas. And even though the battle was won, I feel like we lost it. I spent so much energy on it. Honestly, I'm exhausted, and I'm so caught in it. I almost feel I'm the one who caused it. This ain't what I'm in hip-hop for. It's not why I got in it. That was never my object for someone to get killed. Why would I want to destroy something I helped build? That wasn't my intentions. My intentions were good. I went through my whole career without ever mentioning to me. And that was just out of respect for not running my mouth and talking about something that I knew nothing about. Frustrates on me, stay out. This just wasn't my beef, so I did. I just fell back, watched and gritted my teeth while he's all over TV. Now I'm talking to a man who literally saved my life. Like, it, I understand this is business, and this here just isn't none of my business. But still knowing that it could pop off at any minute. To be a time when you could just say a rhyme and wouldn't have to worry about one of your people dying. But now it's elevated, cause once you put someone's kids in it, it just gets escalated. It ain't just words no more, is it? It's a different ballgame. You call names and you ain't just rapping. We actually tried to stop the 50 and Javi from happening. Me and Dre had sat with him, kicked it and had a chat with him, and asked him not to start it. He wasn't gonna go after him until Josh started gabbing in magazines how we stabbed him. If it be smashing, mash on him, let him have it. Meanwhile, my attention's pulled in another direction. Some reception, except the source who answers phones at his desk has an obsession for me and thinks that I'll be his resurrection. Tries to blow the dust off his mic and make a new record. But now he's f***ed the game up, cause one of the ways I came up was through that publication, the same one that made me famous. Now the owner of it has got a grudge against me for nothing. If that other sucker could get it too. But I'm so busy being pissed off, I don't stop to think that we just inherited 50's beef with Murder, Inc. And he's inherited mine, which is fine. Ain't like either of us mine. We still have soldiers that's on the front line. He's willing to die for us as soon as we give the orders. Never to extort us, strictly to show they support us. Or maybe shout them out in a rap or up in a chorus to show them we love them back and let them know how important it is to have Runyon Avenue soldiers up in our corners. The loyalty to us is worth more than any award is. But I ain't trying to have none of my people hurt or murdered. It ain't worth it. I can't think of a perfect way to word it. Than to just say that I love y'all too much to see the verdict. I'll walk away from it all before I let it go any further. But don't get it twisted. It's not a plea that I'm copping. I'm just willing to be the bigger man if y'all can quit popping off at your jaws with a knocking. Cause frankly, I'm sick of talking. I'm not gonna let someone else's coffin rest on my conscience.
Yes, that was Eminem with Like Toy Soldiers. I just want to say hello to all my live listeners, all three of them. But I am going to just play two songs later on that I played in yesterday's intro to Download 2013 Day 2 with me, DJ Jinx. Or as I put it yesterday, Jinxy. The first one going to be Earth Tone 9 with Amnesia. and then it will be Young Guns with Bones. Feel free to come into the chat and request your songs. But as that's progressing, I will play you some Avenged Sevenfold with Almost Easy. Yes, that was Almost Easy by Avenged Sevenfold. We've got a new person in the chat. Well, it's me. I was just seeing if my picture came up on my Spreaker page, and it has. So I'm all good. It's all good. Up next will be Brompton Cocktail by Avenged Sevenfold, and then going back into some Eminem with Love the Way You Lie.